Hello, everybody. This is Daniel Babis from Daily Soap Dish. If you are new here, please hit that subscribe button down below and hit that bell for the notifications. We cover a ton of 90 Day Fiancé here on the channel. All right, so let's get into it. Today, we're going to be talking about Andre Castrovet and Elizabeth Podhast and their tumultuous relationship, and also an interview that they both did with Entertainment Tonight yesterday. Well, that was published yesterday, in which Andre and Elizabeth attempted to defend Andre's behavior towards Elizabeth. So, as most of you know, most of you that have watched know, Andre seems to really kind of flirt with an abusive kind of side of himself, at least recently on the show when he talks to Elizabeth, at least verbally, let's just say, verbal abuse. I mean, we saw Andre kind of scream and just kind of put down his wife just recently, swearing at her and even maybe calling her the C word. I mean, that part was bleeped out, so we're not exactly sure, but a lot of people think that that's what he called his wife in the heat of the moment. So a lot of controversy with this couple, mainly because Andre is coming across like an abusive husband, and Elizabeth seems to be kind of taking it and making excuses for it. And so this has been a topic in the online world, with people having all sorts of opinions on this matter. And this is exactly why Andre and his wife Elizabeth came on Entertainment Tonight yesterday and in this interview to try to kind of quell or just to remove those rumors or those concerns that he is indeed abusive towards Elizabeth. Now, I have to say, I watched the interview, and honestly, I have actually more questions now than I did before. I don't feel like Andre or Elizabeth were able to remove these doubts whatsoever. So let's just kind of talk a little bit about what was discussed in this interview. So basically, it was, like I said, it was kind of like the tone, the aggression, the kind of, flirting on the abusive side, at least verbally. And that was kind of discussed. That was the topic of the conversation. So what did Andre and Elizabeth say? Well, Andre said that, things like that kind of happen, and he kind of tried to excuse himself, or actually, no, sorry, it was Elizabeth that tried to excuse the behavior of Andre, and she said that, he's a man, he comes from Moldova, and this is kind of how people, I guess, over there act. By the way, I was born in the same part of the world, and I have to say that is complete BS. That is not true at all. People like that, they don't act like that over there. It's just, this is an Andre thing. It has nothing to do with Moldova or that part of the world. This is just an individual thing. So I'm going to correct Elizabeth on that. That is not true. And she said that, oh, he's also a strong person and things like that. Well, I have to say, this all sounds like excuse making, because whenever someone kind of screams at you, swears at you, and visibly puts you down, that is considered abuse. And the fact that Elizabeth is kind of making these excuses for him kind of shows that she might actually be in some kind of an abusive relationship. I mean, all the signs are there that, like I said, I'm not saying that it's physical abuse, I'm talking about verbal. But verbal abuse can lead to emotional abuse, and so this is kind of the issue. Now look, a lot of people in the comments agree with this. Actually, I don't feel like Andre and Elizabeth were able to fool anybody. Everybody still thinks, in fact, more now than before, that this is exactly what's going on, and Elizabeth is just making excuses and, in fact, enabling his behavior with the way that she is excusing it by saying he's a man. He's a strong person. This is also another thing she said. But the thing is, though, a strong person doesn't have to put other people down. That's the thing. That's the part that I don't really get. So what I'm getting at here is that perhaps Andre is actually gaslighting Elizabeth into her believing that his behavior is okay and it's normal. Because also in this interview, they also talked about, I believe it was mainly Andre, they also talked about how other couples go through this kind of thing, and in fact is most likely way worse than what they're going through. Well, I have newsflash. I don't think that, look, personally, I don't talk that way to my wife. If you're a man and you talk that way to your wife, well, it's wrong, and I don't really, I hope that that's not the case. I don't feel that's the case. It's not the case with most of the people that I know, or pretty much all of the people that I know. Of course, you can know everybody's personal life, but it's just not really what I feel is in tune with reality, especially reality in 2020. So this is why I feel that Andre is actually gaslighting Elizabeth into kind of doubting what she would normally see as a reality, especially as an American woman, that, you know, a man kind of talking down, swearing at you, putting you down, well, that's not okay. That's the traits of someone that is abusive verbally, that's the traits of someone that might be a chauvinist, and so on and so forth. However, she is excusing it, and she is making up all these stories about why it's okay, and Andre is strong, and so on and so forth. The thing is, this is kind of typical behavior of people that are abused. And so this is why I'm saying that Andre is gaslighting, Elizabeth. And also, Andre is not, he is not sorry whatsoever for what he did. He is not sorry for the way he's behaving at all. In fact, he is doubling down on his behavior, and he's actually saying in the interview that a lot of times Elizabeth is just as bad, if not worse than he is, I believe, or just as bad. Regardless, he's saying that she can be just as bad as him, but it's never caught on camera. Well, Elizabeth didn't really seem to agree with that. That seemed more like words that Andre was putting in her mouth. So again, kind of trying to change the narrative, make himself look in a good light, and kind of put the blame on Elizabeth, which was also the theme of this entire thing. I mean, Andre took no blame whatsoever for completely losing his temper and just going off on his wife. He took no responsibility for that, and in fact said that it was Elizabeth's fault because she kind of said something, she told him to shut up or something like that, and it kind of just escalated from there. So and Elizabeth actually agreed with that. She said, yeah, I kind of started by telling him to shut up. Look, that is no excuse, okay? It's no excuse. Telling your spouse to shut up is not the same as calling your spouse possibly the C word and swearing at them. And not only that, but we saw in that exchange between them, Elizabeth was just trying to talk to the camera, and Andre was just so aggressively just trying to put her down and to make her not able to talk and prove her point. I thought that moment right there was completely despicable, and it just kind of showed his character. The fact that he is not willing to apologize for that, to me, is disgraceful, I have to say. This is not a strong man. A strong man does not behave that way towards his wife, and then just acts like it's okay, and other couples are way worse, and he is totally fine, and it's all her fault. That is not what a strong man does, okay? It's just not. I'm sorry. That is just ridiculous. And so basically, this entire interview was a complete fail, with Andre just backpedaling and Elizabeth just making all these excuses for her husband. Look, I think it's ridiculous. I don't think anyone buys it at this point. And I think that the more that Andre and Elizabeth give these interviews, I think the more that people are starting to see through their facade. Because on Instagram, they have all these pictures there. They seem nice and happy, but these pictures seem a little phony. And I think that when you hear them in these conversations, in these interviews, and look, Andre was terrible at defending himself, because when you make a mistake, you know, you're supposed to own up for it. If you want to have a good image of yourself in the media, you own up to your mistake. You say, look, you know, it was a bad day. It was stressful. We were jet lagged, which, by the way, Elizabeth said that they were jet lagged, or maybe it was Andre. But it wasn't really put together very well. It was just, they just kind of brushed it off. You know, you excuse yourself. Sometimes you won't act like the best version of you. However, what makes me believe that, you know, this is something that is not just because it was jet lag or some other lame excuse, but that is more typical behavior, is the fact that Andre just doesn't seem to see that his behavior was wrong. That's really what's damning to me. And look, I don't know. Elizabeth, she seems like a smart girl, so I don't know why she's making all these excuses for him. I don't get it, of course. And, you know, on top of everything else, you know, like Elizabeth says that Andre is a strong guy, he, you know, all this stuff, but look, the dude, he doesn't have a job. He had to mooch off a free wedding in his own country from her dad. He didn't even have the guts himself to go and ask Chuck for the money to host that wedding. On top of that, Andre also bullied Elizabeth into converting to Orthodoxy, Christian Orthodox, which is the religion in Moldova, Romania, Bulgaria, Russia, Greece, which is where I'm at right now, but anyways, which is the religion in lots of parts of Eastern Europe. So he didn't have the guts to ask Chuck himself. He didn't have the guts to face Chuck and say, look, Chuck, I'm a bum. I can't pay for it myself, but would you please help me out? Because this is important to me. No, he sent his wife there to do the dirty work for him. And he wasn't even content that he got the money. He asked for how much. He was expecting a lot, probably more than he got even. Look, I think this whole situation is ridiculous. It's hard to see it any other way. It's hard to see it through the rose-colored glasses that Andre and Elizabeth are trying to portray it as. And I would say that if there is abuse going on, Elizabeth's behavior would fit in just typically with the way that other people in similar situations would act, which would be to excuse the behavior of the abuser. And like I said, in this case, it does look like there's gaslighting going on with Andre just trying to kind of almost brainwash Elizabeth into thinking that his behavior is okay, and in fact, she is just as bad as he is. Of course, we have never seen any of that ever on 90 Day Fiancé. So it just does not seem like in the realm of possibility or in the realm of reality. And so, look, I was flabbergasted by the whole thing with Andre, and I was flabbergasted by this interview. I hope that this guy changes his behavior, but the way that he comported himself in this interview and the way he comports himself in general just does not look very promising to me. So I think that there's only two reasons why Elizabeth is putting up with this. One, either she is indeed somehow abused to some extent, which based on what we see on the show, it would seem like it's clear that there's at least some verbal abuse going on, potentially some emotional abuse. Or two, Elizabeth is putting up with this because this is her 15 minutes of fame and she is enjoying it and she wants to write it as far as it takes her, and Andre makes for some good drama, I guess, and allows him to come back on the show. The fact that he is kind of like a bit of an a-hole is good for TV. I'm not exactly sure. Based on his actions recently, I can't say that I'm a fan, but maybe some other people out there find him interesting, and maybe this is what Elizabeth thinks, that just staying with this guy and excusing his behavior and just letting all of this go on makes for good TV, and it will help propel her perhaps into some other things, because of course Elizabeth is known, her job description is actually an actress. Now I haven't seen her in many movies, but that is what she supposedly does. So perhaps she's thinking that this is the way to go. Look, I don't know. You guys let me know what you think. Am I being too harsh on Andre? You know, does he deserve another chance? Look, I don't know. Perhaps I am just, I am wrong. I don't know. But based on the comments, and I can read you some, by the way, they are not pretty. People seem to agree with me. Let me just open up my computer quick here. She is so blind to him being a jerk. She makes too many excuses for him. His father is nice and so is his mother. His horrible attitude is inexcusable. This is someone kind of bringing up the point where Elizabeth was talking about Andrei being Moldovan and how it's his culture and people are cutthroat in Moldova and things like that. People are saying that actually Andrei is not even as good as his own parents, who seem very nice and very normal and all that stuff. She wanted an alpha male, or her version of an alpha male. I don't think an alpha male would be living off his father-in-law, but either way, she makes excuses for him, so I have no sympathy for her. She is totally making excuses for him like an abused wife would. So all of what I'm saying seems to be echoed by people out there. There are not many people that seem to buy their excuses. So look, I don't know. This is what I feel as well, but maybe we're wrong. Who knows? So let us know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already done so, and we'll see you guys on the next one.